The Woman Member of Parliament for Toro District, Sarah Opendi, has today appeared before the Parliamentary Health Committee, which is jointly working with the Committee on Trade, unjustified proposals contained in the Alcoholic Drinks Control Bill 2023.
Alcohol also contributes to the many road accidents that we have seen in the country. And according to a study by Tumwesigye et al. 2016, 15 to 20% of the border accidents treated at Mulago Hospital alone are due to alcohol users, and this costs government money.
In clause 14 of the bill, Opendi is proposing to regulate time within which alcoholic drinks are sold in Uganda by limiting sale of alcohol to only 5 hours during weekdays and 12 hours during weekends. And she proposes a fine not exceeding 1,000 currency points, which is 20 million shillings, or imprisonment for a period of 10 years, or both for those who sell alcohol outside provided hours.
We shouldn't be happy to see Uganda as the country that takes the gold medal when it comes to alcohol consumption. I know the breweries and all those others selling alcohol want to sell, but let us sell this beer also within time. People need time to go and sleep and rest so that they can have energy for the next day.
Is there any public outcry that alcohol is causing them problems? Are local governments realizing that there is economic loss in not licensing the production of alcohol, and therefore they want to make a kill? Why I'm mentioning this is that the presenter of the bill seems to have a lot of interests here and there.
Opendi, in clause 25, wants ban on the sale or supply of an alcoholic drink to a person below 18 years of age by proposing a penalty in clause or a fine not exceeding 2,000 currency points, which is 40 million shillings, or imprisonment for a period not exceeding 3 years or both.
There is a difference between the age categorization indicated in the bill and the one that is indicated on the policy. The policy indicates 21 years, while the bill indicates 18 years.
The stakeholders that we met definitely argued against the 21 year and said we should abide by the 18 years. And that's why you see we had to abide by the 18 years as the year of which is stated in the Constitution as the adult year.
In clause 22 of the bill, Opendi is seeking to prohibit the manufacture, importation, or sale of alcoholic drinks without license.
I know of an MP who used to go to Kawempe, some place, but buy those bottles and sackets to just go and take and make people drunk. You are making people actually drown in poverty just because you want to remain as a member of parliament. We must be serious and tell people the truth. People must be able to work, be productive, so that they can take care of themselves and their families, and we shall have peace.
It affects majorly the younger generation, and we have a population of 70%. Therefore, I call upon you to support Opendi's bill to make sure that we regulate the consumption of alcohol in this country as a way to control our generation.
The bill seeks to repeal the Enguli Act and the Liquor Act Cap 93, the Portable Spirit Act Cap 97, and Enguli Manufacturing and Licensing Act Cap 86, which are presumed obsolete. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.